right, YouTube. Just landed a score of old engines there today. Didn't really expect to find anything when I rolled out of bed this morning, but anyways, come across these. A fella I got a couple engines off of a couple of years ago. That one, and this guy were put outside yesterday. He pulled them out of his basement. I guess he figured he's getting old and time to clean up. They've been outside less than 24 hours, and I stopped by to visit them, and I said, well, how about I take those off your hands for him? So we did. This guy here, the upright, 2-horsepower upright Fairbanks, it's been only outside maybe 2 months, and he did have the ports covered up. Anyway, she's a little bit seized up. The crankshaft's free. The crank is wiggling. Piston's mildly stuck. This here is a 1.5-horsepower Fellows & Company. I'm being told that it's Gould, Shapley, and Muir after they went out of business. This guy turns over, valves are free. The camshaft bearing is totally wiped out of it. This little guy here is another 1.5-horse. Chore boy. Old Waterloo. And she's free also. I got a serious case of too much stuff in the shop and not enough room right now. Little Fairbanks Morris ZD, I believe this is. Kind of square, little ugly bastard, but face only a mother could love. It's got the magneto on it still, which is surprising. Kind of interesting with the camshaft, pulley off the camshaft, as well as the crankshaft. Here's the hopper-cooled upright 2-horsepower Fairbanks Morris. I do have the name tag for that. It's over on the workbench. This one here, I think pretty much all of these would be a runner with a little bit of work. But this one's fairly complete. And this here is my first little air cool job. A little bit of damage to the fan there. Nothing we can't straighten out a little bit there. She's also free. This here is Busy Boy by Associated Manufacturer Company out of Waterloo, Ohio. Also a 1.5-horse. Also come with this purchase was a 6-horsepower. This is a 3-horsepower International M. A 6-horsepower International M came with this purchase, but I haven't brought it back to the shop just yet. Anyways, let's go over here and get the nameplate for the Fairbanks. The old fella thought he was gonna scrap it, so he pulled the nameplate off, and fortunately I was able to come around and grab it before the scrap man got everything. I'm not sure if this is a C5900. Maybe somebody can elaborate on that. I gotta get on the internet and look up Fairbanks serial numbers. They've got a pretty good archive of them as well. Anyways, we'll probably get a bunch of these running over the next little while there, so keep in touch.